Hi guys, Zach at High Performance Academy here. Just struck a little bit of an interesting situation on our SR86 endurance race car here. So what I'm doing is I'm filming a new worked example for our CAN bus communications course. The problem that we're trying to solve is that we have four wideband O2 sensors in this vehicle, so that's one in each runner. They're before the turbocharger though, and when you apply pressure to wideband O2 sensors, which there will be in the exhaust manifold when the engine's at high RPM and under a bit of load, it skews the reading of the wideband O2 sensors. So the controllers that we've got in this vehicle, which are Link CAN landers, can actually compensate for that and bring that reading back to where it should be. But they need a reliable source for that exhaust pressure measurement. So what we're doing is we're getting the Motec M150 that's in the vehicle to read the exhaust manifold pressure through a 0-200 PSI absolute pressure sensor. That's going to our C125-, which we're using as a gateway ECU, and our C125-- is then sending that through to the Link CAN landers. Now that sounds reasonably complicated, and it is, and it actually isn't. It's not too bad when you get into it, but that's what the entire worked example that I'm filming here is going to be about. So that's going to be released with our CAN bus course very, very shortly. The problem I've struck though is that, and this is a problem that you strike all the time in the race car world, is that the parts didn't turn up on time. I'm here for a fixed amount of time to do the job, and that pressure sensor just didn't come in, which is a little bit of a problem. So the way we're getting around that, because I need to make sure that the calibration of everything is correct, is I'm using a potentiometer to fake that sensor. So a variable potentiometer, what that is it's basically a resistor divider. So our wiring fundamentals course actually goes through resistor dividers because they're pretty important things to know about. But basically, if you have one voltage level, say 5 volts, a ground voltage level, we'll call that 0 volts, and then you've got a couple of resistors in between that, this point in between the resistors, the voltage that you'll see there is related to the upper resistor and the lower resistor. Now, what a potentiometer does is it lets you move this voltage level. So you can have a really tiny resistance up top and a big resistance down below, and that voltage will get closer to 5 volts. We can have a really tiny resistance down the bottom, a big resistance up top, and that gets that voltage that you see at the output there closer to the ground level. So what that is going to let me do is it's going to let me easily get a variable voltage into that input channel on the ECU between 0 and 5 volts, and I can then check that the calibration inside the ECU is correct. Now the sensor I'm setting it up for has a linear output scale, and 0.5 volts corresponds to 0 PSI, and 4.5 volts corresponds to 100 PSI. So it's an absolute pressure measurement. So we are going down to 0 PSI or full vacuum and up to 100 PSI. So you call that 0 to 700 kPa as well. So the way I've physically set this up is I've got my electronic test toolkit here, which comes with just a really nice potentiometer in a case. That's got 3 output leads, so that's the upper, the lower, and kind of the middle of that resistor bridge. And I've been a little bit rough and ready here, and I've actually just got some spare connector pins. I've plugged those into the wiring harness, and then I've just used some alligator clips to connect everything together. Now, it's absolutely fine to be a little bit rough and ready when you're doing this kind of work, because it's only for a testing purpose. There's absolutely no way the car's going out on the racetrack with anything like this on it. But for me to confirm that the wiring is correct, that the voltages are going to be correct, and all the configuration and the scaling is correct, this is going to be totally critical, because I'm going to go away and probably not be available when the car gets run for the first time with that sensor on it. So we need to know that it's going to be correct. So I've got my potentiometer here. I can vary that input voltage to the ECU channel from 0 to 5 volts. And on my laptop here, I'm just monitoring the output channel. Now, what I'm monitoring here is actually the output channels seen by the C125-. So this is after it's been read by the Motec and then transmitted over the CAN bus. So if I move our potentiometer value here, we can see we are getting a varying pressure reading there. So if I wind that all the way down, we should be able to get to 0. And then you can see that it actually flicks to a really high reading as soon as I get all the way down low. And the reading we're sitting there at is 3,276.7 kPa, which if you live in the binary world every now and again, that number's probably going to mean something to you. What's happening there is that I mentioned before that the scaling on that sensor is actually from 0.5 to 4.5 volts, whereas the ECU is able to read a voltage between 0 and 5 volts. So if it sees anything between 0 and 0.5, it knows that there's an error because that sensor should not be outputting a voltage in that range, and ditto for the high side as well. So if it's anywhere between 4.5 and 5, it knows there's a problem there too. So when it sees that, it defaults to outputting a value of 3,276.7 kPa. Now we'd be able to flag that as being outside of a bound. It will flash up a warning on the dash, flash up an error in the logs, and it will actually disable the system that we're doing all of this to work with, which is that back pressure compensation. We can set up some logic that if the dash sees that value, it turns off the back pressure compensation in the wideband O2s. So just a quick dive into working in the real world with race cars, and it's absolutely the case that parts don't show up on time, particularly with situations at the moment, and you've got to find a way to get around that. So hopefully this will help you out just a little bit next time you find yourself in a similar situation.
If you like that video, make sure you give it a thumbs up. And if you're not already a subscriber, make sure you're subscribed. We release a new video every week. And if you like free stuff, we've got a great deal for you. Click the link in the description to claim your free spot to our next live lesson.